Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that we are studying topic the cycle of glycolysis, or how does glycolysis takes place. When I say glycolysis, it's nothing but breakdown of glucose to form ATP. Now it takes place in cycle. So let's try and find out what is this cycle all about. The cycle of glycolysis. Now glycolysis is nothing but the breakdown of glucose to form two molecules of pyruvate or pyruvic acid. And during this process, at intermediate places, ATP is formed, and this ATP is nothing but energy currency of cell. During the process of glycolysis, we may study about various enzymes like kinases, isomerases, mutases, dehydrogenases, and we need to know their function. The process of glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm and it is anaerobic in nature. It is also termed as respiration in plants. Talk about the cycle of glycolysis. It is nothing but the process to break down glucose molecule, that is a single molecule of glucose, and in this process or cycle, at the end or after 11 step reaction, what you will get is two molecules of pyruvate and pyruvic acid. You can say any of those, either pyruvate or pyruvic acid, both are correct. During this process, intermediate places will produce adenosine triphosphate, which is an energy currency molecule. Now this process takes place in the cytoplasm and it is anaerobic, independent of oxygen. In plants, respiration begins by the breakdown of this simple carbohydrate glucose, and energy in the form of ATP is produced. Students, now this is the actual cycle of glycolysis. Let's see how does it start. The first molecule that is used is glucose, which is produced from the process of photosynthesis. Now glucose in the first step is converted to glucose 6-phosphate. When I say glucose 6-phosphate, it means one additional phosphate is added to glucose. And the enzyme used here is hexokinase. When I say kinase, kinase means the enzymes that have an ability to add phosphate molecule. And why does hexo? Remember, glucose has 6 carbon, C6, so that is hexo means 6 of glucose, and kinase means an enzyme that helps to add phosphate. Now once glucose 6-phosphate is formed inside the cell, the next molecule that is formed or the next intermediate product is fructose 6-phosphate. Now we all know that glucose and fructose both are isomers. When they both are isomers, that time obviously the enzyme that should be used is phosphohexoisomerase. Isomerase is an enzyme that is used whenever isomers are concerned. Once fructose 6-phosphate is formed, the next intermediate product is fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, or you say it as diphosphate. Now you can see from fructose 6-phosphate there is only difference of addition of one phosphate molecule. So obviously if there is an addition of one phosphate molecule, the enzyme that should be used is phosphofructokinase. When I say kinase, it means addition of phosphate. Now this fructose 1,6-bisphosphate immediately splits into two products. One is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, and another one is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now dihydroxyacetone phosphate is a little bit unstable product. It is immediately converted into another stable product, which is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Now remember, two molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate were formed. So obviously, two molecules of glyceryl-DI-3-phosphate will be formed. And the enzyme which is used is triose phosphate isomerase, since dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceryl-DI are both isomers. Once glyceryl-DI-3-phosphate is formed, the next enzyme that is formed is 1,2-bisphosphate glycerate. And the enzyme used here is glyceryl-DI-phosphate dehydrogenase. Dehydrogenase are enzymes that helps in removal. Once 1,2-bisphosphoglycerate, two molecules are formed, then what is formed is 3-phosphoglycerate. And the formation of 3-phosphoglycerate requires ATP. So obviously, the enzyme that will come into picture is obviously phosphoglycerate kinase. But what you notice is, initially it was 1,2-bisphosphoglycerate, and in the next step, it is 3-phosphoglycerate. So obviously, do you think ATP is removed or ATP is added? You need to figure that. You need to understand that. Once 3-phosphoglycerate is formed, it is immediately converted into 2-phosphoglycerate. Now, the enzyme used here is mutases. Mutases do only one thing. They shift the functional group. So, for example, if the functional group is present at one position in a cell or in a chemical, they just shift the functional group. As you can notice, that 3-phosphoglycerate was converted into 2-phosphoglycerate. So, just the phospho position, which was present at the 3 position or 3' position in the glycerate molecule, was shifted to the 2' position in the second glycerate molecule. And finally, what you get is phosphoenol pyruvate. Now, this phosphoenol pyruvate is formed in the presence of enzyme enolase. Once enolase acts on and forms phosphoenol pyruvate, finally, your required molecule, which is pyruvate, is formed. Or you can say pyruvic acid is formed. Now, this pyruvic acid molecule which are formed are two. And enzyme that was used is pyruvate kinase. When I say pyruvate kinase, obviously the ATP would be involved in this process. Students, this was wholly and solely how does the reaction of glycolysis takes place and how different enzymes like hexokinases, isomerases, mutases, enolases takes into picture. While you are trying to understand this cycle, the first required thing would be to understand what does every enzyme does in this cycle and then go for different enzymes. Here in this reaction, the number of enzymes which are used are very common and very similar. Kinases are used, isomerases are used, mutases are used, and enolase and dehydrogenase is used. Finally, when this pyruvic acid is formed, that is two molecules of pyruvate or pyruvic acid are formed, what do you think? What will happen to it? Obviously, it will go into some another cycle, and that another cycle, which is the Krebs cycle or TCA cycle, which we'll be studying in the later part of the chapter. I hope you all are clear with this concept of glycolysis. Thank you.